So in this video, I'm going to discuss the two most common programming models for multiprocess. The first is shared memory, and the second is message passing. Okay, so you know, shared memory is supposed to be the one that is easier to program in. Okay, so what it tells me is, you know, here's one application, right? So here's an application that has to do all kinds of work. What I'm going to do is break up this work into many different subtasks. Okay, and so, you know, here is the first thread, which is going to work on a certain piece of data. Here's thread 2, which is going to do, again, you know, work on a certain piece of data. It's a part of what the entire application needs to do. And so there are many different parallel pieces of work that can be executed. And all of these threads are going to access one unified pool of data. Okay, so if this thread needs to read something, it reads data out of here. If it needs to write something, it writes data in over here. Same thing with all the other threads as well. So if two threads want to communicate, you know, if both of them, you know, if there's a shared variable A, if the threads want to communicate some data, this thread could do a write into A, and a second thread could read the value A, right? And so this is called the shared memory programming model. This is almost like a bulletin board, right? If you want to communicate with your peers, you go and, you know, post a message on that bulletin board, and everyone can see it, right? And so if anyone stops by the bulletin board and reads it, you know, that's like a read, and that's how you communicate data back and forth. Okay, so this is called the shared memory programming model. There was a second model where, again, you know, you have a single application, it's broken up into many different threads of execution, but there is no longer a common pool of data. Okay, so this thread has access to one piece of, you know, local data. Likewise, this thread has access to local data, and so on. Okay, so now, you know, this thread cannot view the data that belongs to somebody else. If you want to exchange values back and forth, you have to explicitly send messages. Okay, so you send a message saying, I'd like to read variable A. Okay, and there could be a copy of variable A sitting over here. Likewise, there's a copy of A sitting over here. Okay, but somehow the second thread knows that it does not have access to the latest and greatest value of A. So it sends a message saying, you know, give me your latest value of A. And then this one sends a message back. And at this point, this one then, you know, so this thread does a read of A, and then it sends that value over here. And then this one writes that latest value into its local copy. So this is how data gets exchanged between the two threads. So anytime you want to read data, there is no common bulletin board that you can go and read data from. Okay, if you want something, you have to explicitly ask for it. And then whoever has the data will then send it back. Okay, so, you know, when you look at it at first, it appears that, you know, this second model is perhaps a little bit harder to program in. Okay, because, you know, it's not like all you have to do is issue a load instruction and the data is visible to you, right? You actually have to do a send, and so these send primitives have to be part of your program, and likewise, your program has to also include these receive messages at the receiving thread. You know, that thread then has to send back data and so on, right? So there is more effort for the programmer to include all of these send and receive messages as opposed to just doing, you know, loads and stores in this case, right? You did a load here, you did a store, and that is all it took to access this this shared pool of data. Okay, so this seemingly is, you know, perhaps easier to program, and we'll go through some examples and you can be the judge about, you know, which programming model is easier to work with. Your communication is implicit, that is, when I do a load and a store, somehow the underlying hardware does what it has to do to make sure that I get the latest value of data. Okay, because it's possible that this thread may have done a write into A, but that value is sitting in a cache over here. Okay, so when I try to do a read of A over here, it is a responsibility of the hardware to recognize that the latest value is sitting in this cache, and this then gets sent to the reader. Okay, so there is perhaps a little bit more onus on the hardware to make sure that the values are being propagated correctly. Whereas in message passing, the onus falls more on the programmer. Okay, because it is the programmer's responsibility to issue these send and receive messages. And, you know, yes, there is caching, but that is not very problematic because ultimately this thread, you know, issues a load, it gets the latest value of A, and then it has to ship this value across. Okay, so caching. So the fact that A is sitting in multiple caches is not as important because only a single thread will access that cache data, and it will do a send, and the value goes over the network and then gets copied to somebody else's cache, right? And all of that is being done through software instructions, basically the sends and the receives. Okay, so there's no cache coherence, the hardware is simpler, but the programmer is now having to work harder because they have to explicitly send values back and forth. Okay, so it is supposed to be a little bit more software intensive and a little less hardware intensive. Okay, so in the next video, I'll go through a very detailed example of an application and how it can be parallelized with both shared memory and message passing.